It's my absolute pleasure to reintroduce you, or perhaps just plain old introduce you, to products that were near and dear to my heart back in the early 2000s, Artgirlz Charmz. They were the creation of Allison and Tracy Stillwell, two incredible artists who were blurring the lines between fabric, paper, and other mixed media products in wonderfully quirky ways. We're beginning with four styles of charms, and in today's video, I'll show you some fun ways to create with them. The world is pretty darn large, spanning the earth wherever artists and art makers live. It was my pleasure to know and work with Allison and Tracy Stillwell back in the day when their Artgirlz business was active. Fast forward 10 years and Tracy reaching out to talk about charms and the possibility of us producing them as a Joggles product. Then fast forward again to today, and I'm thrilled beyond measure to share that we've brought back four of the most popular Artgirlz charms. So you can see them here, but in essence, what it is the large crown, let me slide these back, the large crown, the large face, and then the straight arm, and the striped legs. So we have these four, and with them you can build some really interesting things. Now what was very different 10 years ago was that we didn't have a laser, but since we do now, it only makes sense to combine something cut on them with the charms. So again, sliding things out of the way, I designed two little dresses. Now these only measure 2 inches from top to bottom, but you can see that there's two hemlines and two necklines, so a scoop neck and then a V-neck. The paper is 140 pound. It's the standard Strathmore 140 pound cold press water paper that we use for everything. So they're going to hold up to kind of all of the things that you might throw at them. You can use all different kinds of things on them, whether you're talking about sprays or inks from an ink pad, all of that kind of stuff will work. So here's the thing. My well-known inability to clean up one project before I start on another led me to realize that you can use lots of different things for bodies besides these pre-cut pieces. For that matter, if you want to take a piece of watercolor paper and cut it into an appropriate size triangle, you can use that too. But what I discovered when I was working with, this is the studio light, the plywood scenery. This was last week's video, I think. See this tree right here? Well, it's the body for this doll right here. I added some color with ink sprays, and then I went ahead and put some pieces on. So I'm going to start with the paper dresses, and then I'll show you how to use elements like this to make fun dolls like that. As I mentioned in the last segment, you can add color to your dresses however you choose. Ink pads, sprays, all of those kinds of things. And as I said, the dresses are about 2 inches tall, so from top to bottom you've got that 2 inches. So you have a little bit of room to work with. You can see I've done a little bit of doodling and embellishing. You can go far further than I have. It's really just a matter of taste and what you feel like doing on any given day. So once you have your dresses ready to go and you're satisfied with them, it's time to think about attaching the arms and legs. So Brad's pretty self-explanatory. I'm going to focus on putting the arms and legs on with some DMC floss. Now the thing to know is that the dresses don't include holes. I'm giving you options to use them however you want. So let's slide this out. This is just an awl. And let me grab, okay, so I have this one in process, and you can see that I've put the arms on, so I'm going to turn this toward me. You can choose your placement of legs. You can put them kind of close together in the center. You can spread them a little bit further. I'm going to put these two a little bit closer in the center than I have on the others. So I'm going to come in maybe a quarter of an inch, and I'm just going to push to make a hole here, and then I'm going to push to make kind of a corresponding hole here, if I could get it lined up where I wanted it. And honestly, the fun thing about these is the quirky character of them. So if things are off and they're not perfectly straight, more the better as far as I'm concerned. All right, so here are my legs. Now, you can put your feet. So if I bring back in this one, is it this one? Yes, her feet are both going the same way. So it looks like she's walking in one direction and her head is turned. Well, get out of there. Her head is turned and looking at you. So that's an option, or you can do this and have them so that if you were standing normally, that's how your feet would kind of look. I have a needle with a reasonably straight eye. It's not a big fat needle. It's just enough to kind of get through the paper. All I'm going to do is come up through the back. And I will tell you that I have put these arms and legs on in the wrong direction more than once. Sometimes it works the first time, sometimes it doesn't. It depends on where my brain is on any given moment. But if I put this on like this, and I put that on like that, and yep, it's sure enough, it's backwards. That's the story of my life. I do it wrong all of the time, but that's okay. We'll come back, and we'll turn this way, and put it on now, and now she's facing the right way. All I'm going to do is tie a square knot on the back. Now you can pull this up tight if you want, or you can leave it a little bit dangly. I like to leave it a little bit dangly, so I'm just going to make a square knot. And once I get this knot done, and I'll show you in 1 second, generally what I do is trim the edges of the floss pretty close. Well, all thumbs here. Trim the edges of the floss pretty close, and then I will bury the knot up in the back with a little bit of glue. So you can see that there's some play in her legs. I'm just going to grab some scissors and trim this off. Let's get that out of the way. And this is just the Scotch Quick Dry Tacky. I'm going to put a little bit of a dot on there. And by doing this, that keeps the little ends from the floss from popping out or showing under the edge of her dress. So that's it. That's how simple it is. You would do this to both of them, and obviously you're going to apply your arms and your legs before you go ahead and you adhere them to a tag. But let me bring this in. So this one is kind of ready to go. You can see her arms are ready, her legs are ready. So what I need to do is use something that will adhere to metal, because we've got metal on the back here. And a lot of glues that you'll get them are for porous surfaces only, but the resolution, and this will serve two purposes, is to use something like Dina Wakely's Ultra Heavy Gel Medium. It's super, super thick, so it's really going to hold this stuff in place. And in addition to that, it is multi-surface, so it will hold metal to paper. Now, before I forget, if you are going to put things like fibers on the sides of the face, there's two openings in the top of the crown here. If I hold this up, you can see it. If you're going to do that, you should probably do it before you glue it in place. It's just going to make life a lot easier. So I'm going to turn this toward me. Go ahead and put this in here. Now, it's kind of impossible to do this, to get enough in there to hold the face in place and not have it ooze out. So the gel medium dries to a matte finish. What I'm going to do is put this on there, and it's already oozing out, but that's okay. I'm going to grab some more to do the crown, and then I'll just go back afterward with the edge. I'll clean off my palette knife, and I'll go back with the edge and just clean up anything. Now, that doesn't feel like it's on there enough. I didn't pile enough of the gel medium on the back. You kind of have to get enough on there. If you look at the back of these, I could pick one up. You can see how the inside is kind of recessed. You need to fill that recessed area with enough of the gel medium so that it actually reaches the surface of the paper. And of course, I'm putting this over the hole, so it's going to leave a little bit of a blob on my work surface. All right, I'm not going to worry about cleaning this up now, but if I wanted to, again, I would just clean off my palette knife and come in and scrape that out. I like to wait until the gel medium has set up a little bit. That actually allows me to do some maneuvering with the palette knife without actually, wow, dislodging the piece that I'm putting on there. So that's it. That's how you use, I'm using a tag, but you could use a journal cover. I mean, there's lots of different places to use these. So up next, I'm going to show you how to use the elements from the studio like plywood, like I did here, to create really fun, and in this case, quite seasonal bodies. There are four different sets of studio light plywood scenery, and the only one that doesn't really have a shape that lends itself to creating a doll is set two. So this is two different dolls from two different sets. One of these is set one, and one of these is set four. And let me actually do this so you can see it. So big tree that was used for a different project. I have this tree here, which is this, and then this tall tree, which is this. Now, one of the things that is worth noting is when you look at these pieces, some of them are tall enough so that you can actually build a crown in, and others of them are not, like this one right here. So this one ended up with just this little pointy piece on top of the head, just sticking up there. And I could have positioned this, or I could have snapped that off, and I'm actually going to show you it's pretty easy to break pieces off of this. So taking the shape from the scenery or the background piece is actually pretty straightforward. This is set, I want to say this is set three. So I'm going to use this tree here, and when you look at these, if I just point right there, there's a little tiny tab right here, and there is another one right here. So you have to cut those. Now, you can try to pop these out without cutting them, but I find it's easier to just take an X-Acto knife and go ahead and pop it out, and I generally do this from both sides. That way, I'm sure I'm not going to damage, especially little pieces like this and on some of the other sets, and I've lost my spot here. Oop, there it is. So when these come out, if you have a little bit of leftover plywood where the tab was, and I don't in this case, but if you do, it's a simple matter to just grab some sandpaper and sand it off. Now, obviously, there are no holes for the arms and the legs as these come off the piece, as they come from the package, but it's easy enough to do. Now, this one, there actually is, let me get my awl, there was a hole. This was part of the tree, so I utilized that. This one doesn't have anything, probably at least not in the right spot. So I'm going to grab a pair of scissors, and I'm going to get rid of this because I need to be able to put legs here, and there's not enough room to poke holes right there. So I'm just going to trim this off, just pop it off. And again, someplace here I have sandpaper. If I have a little spot that needs to be sanded, it's easy enough to do, and then it looks fine. Oh, you know what? I'm going to need this. So now what I need to do is find a place for the arms and the legs. So if I bring in a face, and I imagine putting a face here, and I bring in a couple of legs and some arms, I can kind of imagine, whoops, where these are going to go, and that'll help me decide where to place these. So this is going to be a little bit awkward, and I could consider taking that off, or I could just take advantage of the fact that this is going to be wonky. And I mean, that was really always the joy with the Artgirlz products. Everything was quirky and a little bit left of center, and it always made me smile. So let's go with that. We'll imagine that this arm is going to go here, so I'm going to use my awl. I'm not going to get too close to any of the edges because I don't want to break the wood. I'm not going to try to go all the way through. What I'm going to do is get kind of a pilot hole built, and then I'm going to use a needle to finish it. So I'm going to imagine the other arm here. Again, I'm going to kind of mark this. And I would do the same thing for the legs, but you don't need to see me repeat that two more times. So now what I'm going to do is grab a needle, and I'm going to put the needle in the hole, turn this over, and then very gently push, and this will come through. In this way, I can enlarge the hole, and I don't have to, someplace here I have pliers, I don't have to worry about actually breaking the piece of wood. So I can just kind of swivel this around like that, which will enlarge the hole enough so that I can get the needle through when it comes time to feed the floss through. Same thing here, I'm just going to give that a little bit of a push, and I'm going to put my thumbs near where the point of the needle is because I want to support that wood. And if I come back with my pliers, I can pull this all the way through, and then I can do the same thing. I can come back from the back here and just kind of swivel this and enlarge the hole. Now the process to attach the arms and the legs is the same as what I showed you a moment ago, so I really don't need to show you that again either. Bearing in mind that you know everything is probably going to have two arms and two legs, you really can utilize a lot of different things in terms of shapes like the ones from the plywood scenery or other fun things that you might have around. This is wood, obviously, so we're going to come back and we'll talk again about you placing this on here. Even though this is only going to have a head, I still need to think about that. And I would do the same thing that I did the last time, which is to use Dina Wakely's The Ultra Thick Gel Medium. It's going to work on your metal surface, which is non-porous. Obviously, it's going to work on the wood, which is porous. Embellishment. So let's talk about that a little bit. Now, I tend, on these here, which you saw earlier, all I really did was embellish with markers and pens and those kinds of things. But when it comes time for these, they really lend themselves to some 3D kinds of embellishment. Now, stickles, obviously, I used. These are some, I think these are 8OC beads. I just glued them on there so they kind of stand up. I did put stickles on the arms and the legs. I'm not worried about this rubbing off. If I hold this in the light, you can probably see it. I'm not worried about this rubbing off because these are really not going to be handled to any major extent, so I don't see that as a problem. So there you go. I am so excited that we've been able to bring back the Artgirlz Charmz. We have the face, the crown, the straight arms, and we have these striped legs, and I know that I'm going to love working with these.